I decided to change the oil on the Sportster, and it just turns out that the oil filter is properly jammed. So here's what I am trying to do, because I don't have a oil filter wrench. I've taken one of these pliers or whatever they're called, and I'm literally biting it with it. Now I don't care about the filter because I want to change it nevertheless. I'm literally biting it in and forcing it to turn. I think it has budged a bit now, and we'll see how it goes. I'm gonna try to film this, but I'm not sure if that's gonna go well, but we'll try. This is definitely a two-hand job. I have managed to move it a bit, as you can see from the bites, if it's visible at all. I'm gonna try. No, I can't. I need two hands. Hold on. Success, but not as easy as I thought it should have been. Not sure what these are called, but I bought them for some plumbing work, and looks like it works as a oil filter removal tool as well. The important bit is, don't rush the job. Don't go around buying new tools if this is something you don't do very often, and or you don't have multiple bikes. Even if you do have multiple bikes, I'm not sure if these are standard oil filters. So yeah, I mean, if you don't want to save the oil filter that you are actually taking off, I don't think it matters how they're damaged when you take it off, as long as you don't damage that particular thread. There are several videos on YouTube that show you how to get these things off. The thing is, it should not have been so tight in the first place. I don't know if it's over time or it's because an overzealous technician has decided to do his best job, if I may put it that way. Yeah, don't forget, there's gonna be a lot of oil spillage coming in from here. But then I guess that's something that's bound to happen. Clean it as best you can. probably dirty or mud. I should be cautious. Precaution better than cure, they say. Contact.